Dear cadets, assalamu alaikum. How are you at the time of corona pandemic? I hope you are very well by the grace of Almighty Allah. Due to corona pandemic, you are staying home. For this, your education is being disrupted. To recover your loss, we arranged online class instead of traditional class. Cadets, I Al Amin, your ICT teacher, a very warm welcome to each and every one of you to my online class. Cadets, you know that the corona epidemic has now spread around the world. Bangladesh has also been affected by coronavirus. Coronavirus has been hitting Bangladesh since last March. The corona infection is ongoing in our country. So we have to be very careful and cautious to get rid of COVID. Health scientists are advising to strengthen the immune system, so increase immunity to protect yourself from coronavirus. Cadets, to protect yourself from COVID, you can follow the following eating habits. Eat foods rich in vitamin C regularly. For example, lemon, orange, mango, guava, pineapple, etc. Eat eggs regularly. Eat milk or dairy foods. Eat plenty of fruits and vegetables. Limit foods and drinks high in fat, sugar, and salt. Choose both plant and animal-based protein. Stay hydrated. Cadets, our today's subject is information and communication technology. Class 9, Chapter 2, our today's topic, General Troubleshooting. Cadets, after the completion of this topic, you will be able to explain about general problem of ICT devices. You will be able to solve general problem of computers. You will be able to explain the importance of troubleshooting in computers. Okay, boys, let's start our main topic. General troubleshooting. It is unusual that electronic devices have not gone out of order or not created troubles during using. Some problems are very usual, and some are unusual and complicated. Usual problems can be fixed by the users, but they have to take the help of experienced people for the complicated problems. Computers or ICT devices are not exceptions. Those who use electronic devices have noticed that an operating manual is given with every device. The manual contains a section on the last two or three pages entitled Troubleshooting. Troubleshooting is the process of finding out the source of troubles. Usually some questions are given with solutions. The users, according to the nature of problems, solve them following the solution. In fact, troubleshooting is a systematic process of identifying the source of problems in the ICT device in order to solve it. In the manual, usually some possible problem and solution in relation to the ICT device are mentioned. The user, following the basic troubleshooting steps given the manual, can usually resolve the problem in most of the cases. Okay, boys, so we can tell the definition of troubleshooting. Troubleshooting is the process of diagnosis, the source of the problem. It is used to fix problem with hardware, software, and many other products. Importance of troubleshooting. Troubleshooting and maintenance of your technological device are indispensable if you want to ensure that they are constantly functional. Maintenance is essential to keep ICT device working. So we can tell the importance of troubleshooting is unparalleled. Okay, cadets, we are going to describe some general problem and its common solution. Number one problem, computer is not starting up. The solution of this problem is check the main power cable whether the connection is loose or not. Check whether there is power on the main power board. If there is no power on the main power board, change the main power supply unit. Next step, that is at last steps, take the device to the local service center and consult an expert. Next problem, nothing is viewed on the monitor though the system is running. Solution of this problem is turn off the system and unplug the power cable from the main system. Remove the RAM from the slot. Clean up the connectors of the RAM, rubbing them with an eraser. Clean up the slot of the RAM with a hard brush. Turn on the computer without installing the RAM. And notice whether you get any beep sound. If you get any beep sound, turn off the computer and again turn on after installing the RAM. If you get any beep sound, you have to understand that the RAM is faulty. Install a new RAM if there is no display yet. Install the RAM and check again. Faulty RAM is the reason for at last half of the display problem. Next problem, the system becomes very heated and abruptly shuts down. Solution of this problem, open the casing, remove the CPU or processor fan from the motherboard, but don't remove the processor. Perhaps the heat sink is filled with dust that creates obstruction on the free flow of air. As a result, CPU cannot be cooled. Clean up the heat sink and fan and install again. Now after closing the cabinet, turn on the computer again. If the problem is not solved, take the computer to the service center and talk to an experienced mechanic. Next problem, the computer shuts down on its own at every few minutes, but it is not heated. Solution of this problem, check the motherboard carefully and find out if there is any leaking or faulty capacitor has got loosened. Tighten the capacitor and the problem will be solved. Notice very carefully as the computer is running whether any IC or any other component producing extra heat. Be cautious. Let not board the shortage. If it happens, go to the nearest service center. Next problem, the device freezes while running the Windows. Solution of this problem is check whether there is any virus in the hard disk by running an upgraded antivirus. Taking the backup of important data from the disk, format C drive, and reinstall Windows. Next problem, Display freezes when power button is turned on. Solution of this problem. First step, turning off the power button and opening the casing. Carefully remove the data cables and power cables connected to hard disk, CD-ROM and DVD. And after reconnecting the cables, restart the computer. Second step, check RAM, processor, power supply connection separately whether they are faulty or loosely connected. Third step, check the motherboard using the processor, RAM, hard disk, and other related equipment from an active computer. If it is not active, sense the motherboard. Get the job done by an expert hand or taking the computer to a service center. Sometimes this problem persists when the keyboard and mouse port of the motherboard are loosely connected. Set the connection properly. Next problem. The computer repeatedly freezes and reboots automatically. If the cooling fan set over the CPU does not move or cool the system properly, this problem occurs. In this case, switch off the power and opening the cooling fan, check it out. If the fan is faulty, replace it. Besides, check the fan behind the CPU while the computer is running. The problem persists if the computer has any virus. Clean up every drive of the hard disk by running an updated antivirus. Besides, it happened due to the installation of few hardware or program. In that case, uninstall the program and run the computer. Next problem, getting an electric shock when we touch the metal part of the computer. Solution of this problem, if you get electric shock by touching the metal part of the computer, it is certain that computer has no earth. Calling a skilled electrician, get the computer properly earthed. Next problem, the date of the computer is not correctly displayed all the time, or if any option of the BIOS is sensed, it is not properly saved. Solution of this problem, if the complementary metal oxide semiconductor battery of the motherboard loses power, this problem occurs. In that case, set a new CMOS battery on the motherboard. Next problem, showing the message boot disk failure or hard disk not found. Solution of this problem, switching off the power, open the casing and check the data cable connected to motherboard and hard disk drive and check the connecting point of the power cable from power supply unit to hard disk and properly connect it. Set the jumper properly following the jumper setting diagram on the back of the hard disk. Entering the BIOS, check whether the hard disk is detected from the option of the BIOS either manually or automatically. If the problem is not resolved, connect your hard disk to a sound computer and check whether it works or not. If the problem persists, buy a new hard disk and install the programs you require. Get the job done by an expert. Next problem, showing messages like out of the memory or not enough memory. Solution of this problem, usually these messages are shown when you install access programs and we are keeping a lot of programs open. If the computer does not have sufficient memory for installing access programs, this program occurs. Additional RAM can be installed in the motherboard to resolve this problem. Next problem, keyboard is not working. Solution of this problem, shut down the computer and check whether the keyboard is properly connected to the port. If it is not properly connected or the connection is found loose, refix it and turn on the computer again. Clean up the virus by running an antivirus software. If the problem is not fixed yet, install a new keyboard. Next problem, the mouse is not detecting anything. Solution of this problem, check the connecting cable of the mouse to the computer. Change the port to see whether it works. Connecting a new mouse to the port, check it again. Entering the BIOS, check whether the mouse is disabled. If so, enable it and come out the BIOS. If the problem persists, connect a new mouse to the computer. The problem will be resolved. Next problem, no power is viewed on the monitor. Solution of this problem, be sure whether the power button is turned on. Check the AC power cord connected properly to the power outlet behind the monitor. Next problem, the power of the monitor is viewed on, but there is no display on the monitor. General solution of this problem is, check the video cable whether it is properly connected to the computer or not. If the other point of the video cable is not permanently connected to the monitor, fix it. Adjust the brightness and contrast. Next problem, the printer is not giving any printing output. Cadets, it is the last problem of our today's class. So the problem is the printer is not giving any printing output. Solution of this problem, first step, check the power cable connected to the printer. Second step, check whether the button of the printer is turned on. Step three, check if the data cable of the printer connected properly to the computer. Step four, opening the cover of the printer, find out whether any paper is jammed inside the machine. Step five, check whether the cartridge contains any ink, remove the cartridge and fix again after shaking it well. Next step, if red or yellow blinking light is shown, press the reset button of the printer. Next step, if the problem is not solved, install the driver software supplied with the printer. Okay, cadets, now let's watch a video on some common PC problems with solution.
Mouse is not working or it has sticky keys. Cause, dirty mouse or spilled drinks. Solution, replace the mouse. Number two, keyboard is not working or it has sticky keys. Cause, dirty keyboard or spilled drinks. Solution, replace the keyboard. Number three, monitor is not working. Cause, power button not pressed, loose power cable, loose video signal cable, wrong configuration display settings, or bad monitor. Solution, press the power button, check the cables, adjust display settings, or replace the monitor. Number four, No internet connection. Cause, cable disconnected, modem turned off, router turned off, bad cable, or no signal from provider. Solution, connect the cable, turn on modem, turn on router, replace cable, or contact internet service provider. Please take a moment to like this video at this time. Doing this not only helps me, but others find this very useful video. Thank you very much. Number 5, a specific website is not working. Cause, website is down, website link has changed, website link is wrong or typo. Solution, contact the webmaster, check the website link, check for typos in the link. Number 6, file missing on a computer. Cause, user deleted data, user forgot to save data, program removed, system crash, OS reinstalled, or bad broken storage. Solution, check recycle bin, check backup storage if any, restore folder files function, Windows restore point. Latter causes may have no solution, for example, bad broken storage, OS install, or not saving files. Number 7, cannot receive or send emails. Cause, inbox limit size breached, Windows password change, data corruption. Solution, delete all emails, delete all calendar items with large attachments, update password for email client, clear cache for internet email clients. Number 8, the printer is not working. Cause, printer not installed, wrong printer, no paper or ink, bad driver or configuration. Solution, install printer, change default printer, add paper or ink, use correct driver configuration, and adjust it. Number 9, headset or headphones are not working. Cause, sound configuration not set properly, input and output cable connections are not connected properly, or it's a bad headset. Solution, configure playback and recording device, check input-output connections on the computer, replace headset if broken. Number 10, blue screen of death. Cause, bad hardware or drivers, or overclocking the CPU. Solution, check hardware, for example, RAM, CPU, hard drive, GPU. Check CPU clocks and update drivers. Number 11, computer is slow. Cause, background processes, updates, or virus. Low RAM, low hard drive space, or bad hard drive. Solution, wait for updates to finish. Remove virus, add more RAM, make space on hard drive, replace hard drive. Number 12, computer restarts for no reason with message restarting. No reason is what user would say in PC support. Cause, Windows updates, software updates. Solution, finish updates, or you can force updates to Windows. Software updates should not restart more than once. Number 13, computer shut down for no reason, no message or error. Computer goes silent, no beeps. Cause, bad power supply, bad GPU, bad CPU settings. Solution, test power supply unit or replace if needed. Test GPU by removing it. Check CPU and heatsink, replace it with new thermal paste. Number 14, computer is not working as reported by the user. PC support situation. Cause, many things can cause this. More information needed. Solution, refer to previous solutions to troubleshoot. Number 15, computer making loud fan noise. Cause, dust overheating or fan vibration. Solution, remove dust, replace CPU thermal paste, check for loose fans, vibration inside the PC. Number 16, Wi-Fi is slow. Cause, distance from Wi-Fi, overcrowded use, bandwidth limit, signal interference with other devices. Solution, move closer to source of Wi-Fi. Too many people are using Wi-Fi. Change bandwidth limit. Change Wi-Fi signal channel. Number 17, internet is slow. Cause, too many downloads, too many users, internet service provided data throttling, or a virus. Solution, limit downloads, limit users sharing connection. Reset modem, this can help with throttling, and check for viruses. Number 18, can't log in to be Steve C. Cause, password has changed. Account is locked. Solution, reset password, unlock account. Number 19, can't log in after password change. Cause, not using the new password, typo, or locked account. Solution, reset password, carefully type password after account unlocked. Number 20, nothing is working. This is usually reported to PC support. Cause, unknown, need more information. Solution, contact professional PC support or assistance.
Okay, thank you, Cadet, to watch the video. Cadets, you can see there is two MCQ question. It is sample question. Cadets, your today's home task, write what other five problems a computer may have besides the ones listed above. Identify some solution to these problems. Okay, cadets, again, corona awareness. Due to corona pandemic, we are passing the critical situation. So please follow the instruction given by the expert strictly to keep you corona free along with your family and society. The instructions are: wash your hand with soap and water at least 20 seconds after every 2 hours. Maintain at least 2 meter distance between yourself and others. Refrain from going to public gathering. That means avoid going to crowded places. Avoid touching eyes, nose, mouth with dirty hand. Stay home if you feel unwell. Wear a mask. If you want to go out for any emergency reason, you must wear a mask. Overall, keep yourself up to date on latest information about COVID-19 from trusted source. In fine, I would like to conclude my today's lecture here. Please follow the instruction that you see in the video clip properly. Stay home and maintain your personal hygiene. Convey my salam to your parents. I will come in next class with new lesson, inshallah. Wish you all the best. Till then, Allah Hafiz. Okay, boys, now I am finishing here today. Talk to you soon and keep up the good content. Thank you, everybody.